A lot of folks in the Pokemon Unite community think that Garchomp is the worst Pokemon in the game. Like, below F tier. He gets his own rank, he's so bad. And it's really weird to me, because I think he's one of the best in the game. I think he can carry you to a lot of victories. He carried me through Ultra Rank. So, what I want to do today is I want to show you his stats, his skills, but more so than other guide videos that I have on the channel, I want to show you how to play him and what you should be thinking about when you're playing him and like the mentality to have when you play Garchomp. Because again, I think he's really good. And maybe just a mentality shift will help some other folks out there kind of understand how to play him in a little bit more of an effective way. All right, so let's take a look at the stats and his skills first, and then we'll start getting into a little bit more of the nuance of how to play him. So let's go ahead and get started with his skills. He starts with one of two skills, and that's either Bulldoze or Sand Attack. And what Sand Attack does is it blinds the enemy a little bit, and so they can't see as well, and you can actually see that sand effect on the substitute doll. After you do that, you also move a little bit faster. You can see that aura around me. And the other thing it does is it increases your attack speed for a little bit. So I go whoop, and then I actually attack a little bit faster. And we're gonna talk a lot about attack speed when it comes to Garchomp here. The other starter attack he has is Bulldoze, and that just makes him go whoop, poof. And a little area effect damage around him does 1,141 damage. Not really that much, to be honest, in the grand scheme of things, but it did recently get a buff, which made it better than it was before. And before we can go any farther in the video, we absolutely have to talk about how Garchomp's basic attacks work, because if you understand that, you understand Garchomp. If you don't understand that, you're gonna have a hard time with him. So the way he works is that he builds up a gauge of 5 basic attacks, and once he does that, his attack speed starts skyrocketing. So let me show you. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then once we hit that 5, that little green dot, see how much faster he starts going? Oh man, he's like a blender. So, ignore the numbers, because for some reason in practice mode, Garchomp just does absolutely terrible things to the substitute doll. He doesn't do that much damage against other Pokemon, but this attack speed thing definitely happens. Now, you gotta keep this gauge up if you wanna keep this attack speed going. So how do you keep the gauge up? How do you keep those 5 stacks? Well, 1, you can hit things. 2, you can use your special attack, so Dig will do it. Now, Dragon Claw will do 2 stacks ever to be hit with both hits. And something to keep in mind is that it lasts for 4 seconds. So I'm going to hit to 440 here. And then you'll see at 436, it'll disappear. Gone. And you got to start over and rebuild it. So what you really, really, really want to do with Garchomp is keep those stacks going. So you can go ahead and use things like Dragon Claw to reach a little bit farther, or to use Dig to reach a little bit farther. Or run into things with Dig. Use Dig to reach a little bit farther. Go ahead and make it so that you are continuing your stacks. You want to keep those 4 seconds going. Garchomp's power comes from attack speed. And Garchomp's attack speed goes up if he reaches his stacks. It also just goes up as his level increases, which is a really big deal on Garchomp. You want to level up your Garchomp a lot. And we'll talk more about that a little bit later. And now before we forget, let's take a look at his stats. He has 7,750 HP, 420 defense, and 318 special defense at level 15. This is all pretty typical all-rounder stats. It puts him a little bit ahead of Lucario, significantly behind Snorlax, and significantly ahead of something like Pikachu. And one more thing before we go too much farther is we actually have a whole new channel dedicated to Pokemon Unite content. It's called Pokemon Unite Guides. And it's brand new, just started a couple of days ago. And it's pure Pokemon Unite content, Pokemon Unite and nothing else. So if you like Pokemon Unite a lot and you want to get some real specialized content, or you really like how deep I go into videos here, I'm going to do even more of that over on that channel. So be one of the first people over there. You'll get bragging rights, get us to 1,000 subscribers, and I'd really appreciate it. So with that, let's continue the video here. So let's go through a few more skills so we can get through the skills part of the video, and then I'll talk a little bit more on how to play Garchomp. So the two skills I have equipped here are Dig and Dragon Claw. So what Dig does is you go through and you pop up out of the ground. And now if you hit a Pokemon, that makes them pop up, stuns them a little bit, and then they take 865 damage, which is very low. That is not very good for a level 15 version of a skill. Now, another thing that happens with Dig Plus when you get that upgraded is that Garchomp takes less damage, and it's about 25% less damage. So he's hitting 72 right here. And then if I were to go ahead and go this way, you'll see that I'm taking less damage. It's about 25% less damage. And now something really interesting about wild Pokemon is their damage goes up as the game goes on, in case you didn't know. Take a look. The 74 is about to turn into a 76 at around 802. See? It happens at regular intervals during the game. And I don't know, it's just a little trivia, I guess, because you are leveling up as the game goes on, so it's probably not that big a deal, but they do do more damage as time goes on, which I found really, 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 really interesting. And then something else to keep in mind here, as long as we're down here, is Garchomp's passive. So Garchomp's passive causes the enemy to take 36% of the damage that they deal to Garchomp. So if you deal 100 damage to Garchomp, you're going to be taking 36 damage. And it seems like, based off of what Autono's doing, there is not a cooldown on it. So be careful, he's going to melt you. And then his passive's called Rough Skin, and again, what it does is it just causes retaliation damage. Now on to Dragon Claw here. What Dragon Claw does is it swipes forward twice, goes rah, pah, pah, pah. And then the first attack here does damage, and then the second attack does more damage. And then level 15, Dragon Claw does 1334 damage, but then Dragon Claw Plus does 1581 damage. So the upgrade gives you about an extra 18% damage. Another thing to know about Dragon Claw is that it can critical hit. I wouldn't be surprised if it does right here. Oh, no critting. Eventually, you'll see one of these crit. So a lot of his skills can benefit from critting, which, there we go. So if you're rocking a scope lens or something like that, you might get a few more of those to pop out. Now, something else to keep in mind with Dragon Claw is your attack speed goes up a little bit after you use it. So wa-bam, ba-bam, you get those two stacks on your boosted attack gauge, and then you actually attack a little bit faster to help get you to those five stacks, which is kind of cool. And then also, if you're already at five stacks, I would be surprised if your attack speed goes even higher. Yeah, it does. So you get a little bit more attack speed, which is a really big deal on Garchomp because he's all about attack speed. Something I really, 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 really recommend you do with Garchomp is to go into your settings here and go to controls and then turn on boosted attack gauge. Because if you don't have that on, you're not going to be able to see these little notches that show up underneath my health bar that let you know how many stacks he has. You definitely want to be able to see those if you're playing Garchomp. And then I guess another cute way to tell if he's all charged up at five stacks is take a look at his little fins. You see how they're glowing red right now? Well, if you let it decharge, well, then his fins stop glowing. So he gets so happy, he's so full of energy. His little red finnies just start glowing. Look at there they are, they're a little charged up again. It's pretty cute. Now let's move on to two more skills here. We have Dragon Rush and we have Earthquake. So what Dragon Rush does is pretty interesting. It causes Garchomp to back up and then shove the Pokemon in front of him. Like that. And what that'll do is if the Pokemon get shoved the maximum distance, they're actually going to go ahead and be slowed for a little bit. So let's take a look at Apom here. It's a very small amount of time, so pay close attention. But Apom's actually going to be a little bit slower after this hit. So, ba-bam. And you see how they are a little slow to get moving? Well, that's one of the effects of Dragon Rush here. And I should clarify that slowing is an effect of Dragon Rush Plus, the upgraded version of it. And the amount of damage that Dragon Rush does at level 15 is about 549, which again is incredibly low for a level 15 skill. It is criminally low. And now the other attack here is Earthquake, which is basically just an upgraded bulldoze. So what Earthquake does is it causes initial slam damage of 847, and then it ticks for another 465 damage twice, resulting in 1777 damage. So it's okay, level 15. Again, not amazing. It does damage in that aura of effect. And then when it's upgraded, enemies within this aura of Earthquake are slowed a little bit. And now before we talk about the Unite move, there's actually one more special thing that Garchomp can do, and it's that he can combo up both of his Dragon skills if he has both of them equipped to create a special attack. So if you take a peek here, what you can do is you can charge up a Dragon Rush and then use Dragon Claw, and that'll cause an extra special attack to happen. So if you do that, you see how he does that extra combo and slashes in, and that results in him doing 2,130 damage. And then if you take a look at Dragon Rush without that combo, you see it looks something like that. Now, let's talk about something that some of you may know about with Garchomp here, and it's a glitch that's happening. Don't get excited about it. We're recording it here for historical sake, because they're going to get rid of it. They're going to fix it. But there's currently a bug in the game where you can toss people basically across the map when you're playing Garchomp, as long as you use these two skills here. So let me try to replicate it here, but basically you do Dragon Rush and Dragon Claw while you're in the air, and then you have to eject button in the opposite direction, and that'll cause that special attack to just go skyrocketing into a different direction. Now let's see here. There he goes. Yeah, so that's a really easy way to toss people whatever direction you want them. And you can do this to regular Pokemon. It doesn't have to be the substitute doll. So if you've had that happen to you, I'm sorry, but I guarantee you they're gonna patch it. So I guess use it while you got it. It's a little bit risky because it's hard to nail. And your eject button has a 70-second cooldown. So if you mess up, Well, then you don't get to have the effect happen, but it does exist, so I'm letting you know about it. This is actually a really good place to show you his Unite move. So his Unite move is called Livid Outrage, and it is exactly how it sounds. He charges forward, and then he just gets really unwieldy, and he starts doing these attacks. I'm not touching the button while he's doing these attacks. Here, I'll show you. You see, like, I don't touch the controller at all. He just does all of these. So really all you're trying to do with Garchomp is steer him. Because you don't get to control the attacks. And now something to know about this Unite move is I'm pretty sure it does the most damage in the game in terms of a Unite move. So let's take a look here. Bam, 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 bam. So Garchomp does over 11,000 damage to a substitute doll with his Unite move. I don't think anything rivals that. Some can get in the 9,000s on some of these characters, but I don't think anything pierces 11,000s. I think it Charizard's up there, and then there's Garchomp. So, that could be really nice when you're in the middle here and you need to secure Zapdos. If you're sitting here, well, pam, 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 and then everybody starts rushing in to try to get steals. If you just start, like, going nuts on him in here, you're going to stun the crap out of everyone, and you're going to be doing a ton of damage. So, I like to save this sometimes for a team fight where everybody's clumped up, or for big objective areas where I gotta clean people out or try to secure an objective with a burst damage. So now we're at the point where we're gonna talk about how to play Garchomp and to give you some tips on how to make your experience with him a little bit more smooth. Now, in my opinion, I would love to be able to jungle with Garchomp. So if you can jungle with Garchomp, I would go ahead and go for it. Hopefully your team allows that if they see a Garchomp on their team. So you get in there and then use a sand attack right here to get your speed up and then just start smacking this little guy around. Now, I'm pretty certain that Ludicolo always spawns closest to the jungler. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he would spawn low if Little Pup would have ran low. But then, go ahead and start smacking this guy. Now, keep in mind what I said about how you want to maintain your stacks of 5 attack. So, pull him a little bit this way, and then go run on over here, get a sand attack going to keep the stacks going. So, you can kind of clear this a little bit faster. Sand attack has a pretty decent range. Like, a little bit farther than what the thingy says. Now, I might not be able to make it over here in time. Maybe I will. You see how it still reaches? Even if it was beyond the arrow? So you just want to keep your stacks going, because that's really where a lot of your speed and a lot of your power comes from. Now, I don't think you can clear the whole thing here. No, you can't. But you can get through those first three pretty quickly with old Gible here. And Gible gets his first evolution at level 6. So a lot of Pokemon, once they reach level 5, they're going to go ahead and try to get into the lane and start ganking. That's not your move here with Gible. Now, you can go ahead and see if somebody's being greedy, because Gible, even at level 5, he's still a blender. He's still a grinder. If people go up to him, they're like, oh, I can take out Gible. He's nothing. Well, if you got stacks going on, he's still going to be able to melt you. He's very deceptive with that rough skin and then also that attack speed combo. If you can get your attack speed going up, you can still probably take people on. But then you want to make sure you try to get level 6 as quickly as you can so that you can get yourself back up. And now something to keep in mind here, as I'm in the middle, getting these junglies, but don't forget to run back and grab these guys right away, because they respawn pretty quickly. And these guys provide way, way more leveling than any of those little core fish do, okay? So, oh, don't touch me, only got me anyway. And remember, your skills will make your stacks go up for your boosted attack gauge, and then so do your regular attacks. So now I have dig, and then I go boop. And the dig is really, 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 really nice because it allows you to traverse a little bit. It allows you to catch up to people like this. It allows you to run away from people. It gives you a lot more mobility. And Garchomp's big thing is that he needs to be close to you. He's a melee character through and through. You need to be close to your enemy. So you don't really want to fight somebody like a Greninja who can kite you really well and then, you know, slow you down. You want to be close to people. You want to... He's a blender. He's a blender. He's a blender. Blenders aren't scary on the other side of the kitchen. They're terrifying if your hand is in it. That's a great way to think about Garchomp. You want to bring the blender to them. Now, Garchomp's really, oh my god, really good at objectives. So something you can do with him, even at level 7 here, is get started on something like Dreadnought. Something a lot of people do is they just, especially in Ultra, I think this is why he was so good for me in Ultra, is that people get scared to do the objective. So Garchomp's really good at getting the party going here in solo queue, because he can just melt stuff and he can sustain himself. One other thing to keep in mind here with Garchomp is he's a late bloomer, which is why jungling is a really big deal on him. He does not turn into Garchomp and get his Unite move until level 10. Late bloomer, similar to Gardevoir. Speaking of which, you never, ever want to have Gardevoir and Gible in a lane together, or Gardevoir and Garchomp. You never want to have them in a lane together because they're both late bloomers. They're going to get destroyed all game. Never put them in a lane together. Ever. Ever, 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 ever. Now, something to keep in mind with Garchomp is he gets more attack speed as he levels up. So if we take a look at this thing over here, I'll probably do a side-by-side here of the attack speed that Garchomp has. So now what if you have to go in lane with Garchomp? Somebody took the jungle. There's no chance you're getting it. You got to take a lane. I always say go top lane. Reason being is that you need to rotate down to Dreadnought 7 minutes. And if somebody else is in the top lane, you don't know what they're going to do, but you know that you are going to go rotate down to Dreadnought, right? So take control of what you can take control of when you're playing solo queue. So some tips and tricks here, I suppose, with old Gible here in the lane. Gible is very vulnerable early. He does not have a lot of mobility. He just runs around like this. The best thing he can do is use a little sand attack, and that makes him run a little bit faster. I think he might have to hit someone to make it happen. Yeah, he has to hit someone, and that'll make him move a little bit faster. So be a little bit more passive when you're playing here with old Gible. Don't rush forward and then feed. You don't want to feed the enemy team because Gible's a little bit weak. Now, in terms of getting experience, you want to try to get your last hits in, so we're back with that big AoE attack when the bees are low. Another thing you can be doing is pay attention to the jungle. So your jungler is going to be trying to clear out all these things here in the jungle, right here. Quit hitting me. He's going to try to clear out these things in the jungle. Now, you don't really want to take any of that away from the jungler, but I would say that most players would be like, okay, well, if we have a Garchomp on our team and he's in lane, they might try to let you take these. Because a lot of junglers just need to get to level 7 to start really pumping out their skills. And you get to level 7 by doing this whole rotation twice. And this whole rotation twice, you know, between Bufaland, Ludicolo, and the two Corphish, that happens twice before Dreadnought. So you're going to be able to get to level 7 before Dreadnought, even if you never touch the middle as a jungler. Another thing to keep in mind is if your jungler is doing a good job keeping up on their jungle, you can pay attention to when they respawn over here. And if they respawn over here, you know that there's a good chance that the enemy teams are respawning. So that gives you an opportunity to sneak around and try to take these guys. Because if you see that their jungler, like let's say an Absol or a Zeraora, is in a lane attacking your teammates, that's a good opportunity for you to sneak around in here and then try to steal a little bit from the enemy's jungle. Use intel based off of what you're getting in lane to go ahead and try to steal a little bit. That way you're still kind of getting the jungle effect on Garchomp, and you're not worrying about feeding while you're in lane with little old Gible, and then you're also hurting the enemy team by taking their jungle away from them. So you got to kind of be careful and play your cards right, but if you can see that their jungler is getting a little too, you know, drawn into a team fight, that's a really good opportunity for you to go ahead and get some EXP on old Ghibli boy here, because again, he's a late bloomer, meaning he needs to get EXP to go ahead and really start shining. But again, don't dive. Don't sit here and get greedy and be like, oh, I'm going to get him. And then like try to attack them in their zone right here. Personally, for a moveset, I run Dig and Dragon Claw. Reason being is that Dig helps you get a little bit closer, helps you maintain the stacks if you need them. And then Dragon Claw also provides stacks really quickly with the two hits. And then you also get that increased attack speed, which helps you get to your 5 stacks even faster. Again, he's a big attack speed character. And the higher his level is, the more attack speed he has. And like, I can sit here probably be at a disadvantage of him hitting me, let him get to level 15. And we're going to win every single time in a 1v1 as long as we can get our stacks up. He doesn't stand a chance. They'll never beat you in a one-on-one as long as you're close to them. So you got to be careful of like Cinderace or Greninja, where they can like kick and run, kick and run, kick and run. Because those guys will destroy you because you just can't keep up with them. But anybody melee or anybody close range, you're always going to win. I can't think of a scenario where you're going to lose a one-on-one in a melee fight if you're Garchomp. And now it's time to talk about where I think Garchomp shines the most, and it's Zapdos. So something I see a lot in Ultra Rank is people are scared of Zapdos if they have the lead or if they don't have the lead, frankly. So what people do is they just kind of dance around the bird because they don't want to get him started because they're afraid of losing the whole match due to a last second snipe from the enemy team. Now, in my opinion, when you have the lead, you want to protect your lead. That does not mean only defend Zapdos. Protecting your lead means making it so the enemy team can't make a comeback. Now, that can be defending Zapdos, making it so that the bird just never dies. But it also can mean taking down Zapdos if you win a team fight. If you're with your team and you take out two or three people on the enemy team, for all means, go after Zapdos. Even if for some reason they do end up sniping with a one or two remaining characters, you're going to be able to probably take them out before they score. You want to make sure you don't give them a chance to come back. If they keep respawning, that is about three or four chances in these last 2 minutes for them to respawn and win one of these team fights. So that means if they win one of these team fights, they're going to all jump on Zapdos because they know they have to. So this is where Garchomp becomes really powerful if you're winning a game. He's really good at dealing with Zapdos. He's the best at it. So you can go ahead, get started here. And then he just is going to do disgusting damage here to Zapdos. Like, look at this. Melt, 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 melt. And then he can do this all on his own. Again, nobody's helping him right now. I don't know what time we started this, but it probably wasn't that long ago. And he's doing this all on his own. My health hasn't even really gone down. He's just been strong this whole time. So if you have a Garchomp on your team, think about just defending him and zoning out to make it so those snipers can't take Zapdos, because he can take out Zapdos all on his own and not even sweat it. That's where I think Garchomp becomes really powerful. The fact that he can push an objective and make your solo queue teammates have to do something. If they see someone on their team going after Zapdos, well, then they're going to try to help you. If everybody kind of mamby-pambies around and is scared to do anything, you're going to lose more often than you win, because the enemy team is in a mode where we have to do something because we have to try to win. We have to attack. And that aggressiveness tends to beat people's passiveness more often, in my experience, in my opinion. So assess the situation. Maybe it'll make sense to only defend Zapdos, but sometimes it makes a lot more sense to take an advantage when you have it and then pounce on it. So now let's talk about items on Garchomp here. I always recommend Buddy Barrier just because it's so good and it gives you so much extra health. And then in the case with Garchomp, with that Livid Outrage, that makes it so he's going to be able to maintain his ability to stay alive during all that damage he's going to do to the enemy team. Buddy Barrier is awesome, and it also helps out your teammates too. I really recommend Muscle Band on him because he's such a basic attack character. So getting that extra damage on really meaty characters can be really helpful for Garchomp. Focus Band's really nice on him because it starts giving him that extra health when he's low, which allows him to get more lifesteal. It also allows him to cause more damage with his basic attacks. It also allows Rough Skin to be utilized longer during the battle. Another thing you could pick is Scope Lens. I could explain Scope Lens, but it's actually a little bit more complicated than you might think. But basically what happens is every single time you hit a critical hit, you do bonus damage. We can talk more about the numbers and all that of the bonus damage, but the bonus damage is based off of what your basic attack damage is. Not based off your critical hit, never mind all that. It's based off of what your basic attack damage is. So you do bonus damage. So you can pick that if you feel like you're hitting a lot of crits with old Garchomp here, but Focus Band is also a really good pick. Garchomp has a lot going on. He's a little bit nuanced. There's some things to understand about him, and I hope this video helped. We stream every single night on twitch.tv/swingpoint, and we do lots of viewer games if you want to go check this game out and play with us on stream. And I also do a lot of requests in case people want to learn a little bit more about a character. I'll play them live for you on the stream. Also, remember to check out the Pokemon Unite Guides channel that I have linked in the description down below. I'd love to see you guys over there. Let me know if you were there, or if you're already over there now, let me know you're over there right now and leave a comment down below. And with that, thank you guys so much for being here, and then I'll see you in the next video that we do around here.